We see a one-for-one trade. Now, it was many moons ago, many years ago, around this time of year, where the infamous quote from Bob McKenzie was, the trade is one-for-one. And we got another one-for-one with Pierre-Luc Dubois, the malcontent, the locker room problem, potentially, moves from Los Angeles to the Washington Capitals in exchange for Darcy Kuemper, who had lost his job to Charlie Lindgren. If we'd forgotten, we were reminded this week that the biggest blockbuster trades in the NHL, not necessarily the trade deadline, it's almost always the week or two leading up to the NHL draft.
Yeah, guys want to get moving and shaking this time of year. Things start to pile on, and it's not a surprise that triggers are getting pulled right now. But with this PLD thing, like we were talking about before, like, you know, as these trades break, one guy tweets something and everyone starts talking, and then details start to flow in a little bit. And we're like, how much salary is going to be retained? What else is going to, you know, come with? Is there going to be like a buyout option where like, is this cap maneuver? Like, and then it becomes one for one. And all I can think of is, why would Washington willingly take on this fresh, heavy problem of the LA Kings willingly, unless they just over the moon believe in this guy, when he's already been through what? Columbus, Winnipeg. Where else is he?
One year in LA.
LA, 1 year with that ticket, and now he's gone. I really thought there'd be more details to this story, but it's one for one, and it's a bit of a head scratcher if you are, you know, the Washington Capitals, unless you truly believe that this guy is who he's supposed to be.
I think you nailed it. I don't think the Capitals do this unless they absolutely believe in Pierre-Luc Dubois. There is a scenario where, depending what day in the next week the Stanley Cup final actually ends, they could buy him out. But they don't have certainty on that. He could be 25 or 26. I don't think they're acquiring this guy to give him like $40 million, pat him on the back and say, go away. I think they believe in the player, or they don't do this. Now, the Capitals are a team that have lost some significant center depth over the last year. You saw Evgeny Kuznetsov, some player safety stuff, then off to Carolina. And prior to that, Nick Backstrom has called it a career. They might just be saying, look, everything's about Ovi. Everything's about like just like extending this superstar's hero in this chase for goals. We don't have a legit great center. Let's roll the dice on all this talent and skill. A guy that looked like a bull in a china shop, flirting with 30 goals and 60 points in markets when he allegedly wasn't happy. You know, the LA moved heaven and earth to get him. And that was supposed to be his happy spot. And it's been worse than any other destination he's had. Buyer beware for Washington. But maybe they're just saying, screw it. We're just going to bet on skill here. This is the most skilled guy we can find for Darcy Kemper's contract. And there's no question he is.
But I mean, buyer beware, of course. Like when you draft guys, you don't know a lot about them. You can't go through a Rolodex of past and see what this guy is and how he fits in the league and everything. You can with this guy, and you think, what was the problem in Columbus? What was the problem in Winnipeg? What is the problem? Like they just signed this guy to a monster, which shows massive commitment, massive liking this guy, massive fit with their crew. You know, what was a 10 short months, 11 short months. And it's like, get this guy the hell out of here. And you find a buyer. Like how often does that happen? I don't really understand it. Pierre-Luc Dubois is supposed to be this power forward with some skill, be able to take over games, be able to be a huge factor. And everywhere he seems to go more and more as time goes on, is he a diva? Is he a prima donna? Is he lacking character? Is he selfish? I don't know, but there is a lot of question marks. And usually when you take on a monster contract, there's not a lot of question marks. Sometimes they don't work out. I get it. But this is one that's already not worked out with a history of not working out with the individual. And you're like, come on to us. And they send Darcy Kuemper, which, you know, you could think of a cap dump or getting rid of a contract or whatever, but they give up, you know, property as well to get this guy. It's I'm kind of scratching my head over this one for how big of a deal it is.
Yeah, Dubois is an interesting one because it's a guy that had back-to-back seasons where he flirts with 30 goals and 60 points and does hit that total in back-to-back years in Winnipeg. And the thought is like, oh, he'd like out of here. It's not a great fit. He doesn't want to be here. Imagine if we could get this guy who's knocking on the door, power forward with 30 goals, 60 points to somewhere he's happy. God, like it'll be unbelievable. And you're looking at LA, you're like, shit, they already got Kopitar, Byfield, they've moved to the wing, but he's a center. Maybe you keep him on the wing now that you got Dubois. Danault is one of the great shutdown centermen. They signed him in free agency a while ago. Like, what a great spot for Pierre-Luc Dubois. He doesn't have to be their best center. He could even be their third best center, and that's probably okay. But probably you just need to be a number two center. Couldn't do the job in the destination that we were led to believe that he'd prefer. This is a very serious gamble by the Washington Capitals to the tune of, like, what? We're talking $50 to $60 million. Like, that's incredible. And Darcy Kemper's not a bad goalie. He just got passed. And for two more, three more years at 5.25, whatever. Kings need a goalie, I guess. But, I don't know how you pulled the rabbit out of hat here, Rob Blake. That's some impressive stuff.
It's not very often you can get into a jam like that with a monster contract with a guy that's not panning out and then just get out of it scot-free. No less get a guy that just won the Stanley Cup a handful of years ago as a goaltender in return. It's just, yeah. He must be dancing right now. And I, honestly, with that deal, I see a lot of red flags, just how quickly he burnt the bridge in LA. Like you said, a place that's supposed to be his happy place, where he wanted to go, where he's able to flourish, where there's a plethora of reasons why he should do well there. And he absolutely burnt it down and cooked it, and he's out of there now. I just can't believe they found a buyer for that situation.
Todd McClellan's job, likely a victim of that. And Drew Doughty with some incredibly pointed comments in season about guys playing for points, playing for themselves, not playing for the team. I know who I'm voting for GM of the year next year. I don't get a vote, but yeah, that's some work from Rob Blake to undo that knot that was left on his desk.
Something to watch, though.
Yeah, sorry, go ahead there.
Just saying, something to watch next season. I mean, we'll see how it pans out. Maybe Washington will look like geniuses. I just can't see. He's still on a big contract. It's not like they stole him. I just see there's a huge potential for it to be a flop, and then maybe it's okay. Like, those are the two things that could maybe happen, and I'm kind of shocked, to be honest, but lots of action to the start of this part of the season, man. It's good stuff.